We are going to see love in the general for the sign of Virgo. So watch this video if you're a Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, or if you're dealing with one. Keep in mind that this is a general reading. It may or may not resonate. If it do not try to deliberately fit in, check in any other placement. The energy can be vice versa. Keep that in mind as well. If you want to have a personal reading, link in the description. If you want to follow my Instagram, link in the description. Sometimes I speak bad words, so if you're very sensitive, you can just click out. Okay, bye. All right, let's see for Virgo. So give me some messages for Virgo, please. So 10 of Wands, what are you burdening yourself with? Okay, so we have Two of Swords and the Queen of Pentacles. So Virgo, just right off the bat, what I see is that you are overburdening yourself with something, okay? Maybe you are carrying the load of expectation of other people. Other people want you to do something in some way and you're trying to take that pressure on yourself. Don't do that. And that's causing a lot of anxiety, ambiguity, okay? You are losing the sense of direction for yourself because you're paying too much attention to what others have to say, what others will think, the load of their expectation, etc. In relationship as well, I see that you are trying to bend over backwards, okay, again, to meet expectations. Don't do that, right? If you try to bend over backwards and you try to make things work irrespective of the other people putting in the effort or not, you lose both the relationship and the self-respect, okay? So don't do it. Some of you, I think you're working really, really hard and you need to take a break because you are doing so much that the path in front of you has become ambiguous, okay? So that's what I see. Some of you, I think you were trying to work a situation with a loved one, your partner. You were trying very hard to work it out with this person, but you were constantly nagging and fighting and etc. So right now you've taken a break. You've taken a step back, which is good. And you know, that is putting you in this mode of sanity with the Queen of Pentacles. So right now you're just focused on your money and your stability. You think that I've tried really hard to make the situation work, but if it's not giving me result, let it be. I'm gonna do my work. So that's the kind of energy that you're carrying in right now. The Queen of Pentacles shows to me that you're very much in your power, okay, and you're doing your work. You are not focused on what others have to say, what others have to do, okay? You're just focused on your money, you're focused on your stability, you're focused on yourself, okay? Some of you, I think someone was confused between you and someone else, and you were like, okay, if you are confused between me and someone else, let me just reduce myself from the option and then there won't be any confusion, okay? So that's great if you did that. Let's see what's coming in love for the Virgo, please. It's coming in for love. So we have the Judgment card again. Yeah, as I said, you know, you sort of lost the path. Like, you were trying so hard to work a situation out with someone, you just lost the path and things became very ambiguous, and now things are on pretty much hold. With the Judgment card, I see someone wants to have a reconciliation, a second chance with you, or maybe they just want that this hold, the situation which is on hold, should somehow reach to a conclusion, okay? Because it is going on for some time. I think some of it, this is going on for last 20 weeks, 20 months, or is also significant. So they basically want clarity. You want clarity for yourself as well, because you think you can't go on in this position where you're suffocated. I see someone is suffocating the hell out of you. Could be a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Sagittarius very strongly, and Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn is here as well. Signs do not matter, I tell, because people are interested. I see that you are in this connection. You haven't really walken off. It's like it's just that you've taken a truce, basically, okay? And this is also causing you anxiety because you think, I can't be in this position of stagnation for very long. Like, I need a proper clarity if it's working or if it's not, okay? So you want a decision to be made. You want clear communication from the other person because the situation is right now suffocating you. All right, let's see the intention of this person you're dealing with. What is the intention of the person my Virgo is dealing with? So we have Two of Pentacles and the Three of Wands. Yeah, I can see some of you were dealing with a juggler. Okay, could be Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Aries, Leo, Sag. So this person was pretty much juggling you with someone else or some other area of life. Maybe they just don't know how to handle situation. Some of you are dealing with someone who gives a lot of priority to their money and career and not you. Like, money and career is important, but that does not mean that they treat you as a second most important thing in their life and etc. So it's not that, you know, everything should go hand in hand. And I see you were dealing with someone who was not making their mind. Maybe they chose an Aries or Aries, Leo, Sag over you. So it's a pretty juggling energy. This person is trying to juggle you and you're not ready to take their shit. What else? What will be the action of this person towards my Virgo next? Seven of Cups. They're very confused. You're dealing with a juggler, a confused person. They have their options open or they're just very confused in life. Ten of Pentacles. Excuse me. They want stability with you, but they don't want to work for it. Six of Cups, they miss you. Really, Eight of Pentacles. See, again, it's like this person needs to put in the work. They can't get things just because they want things, okay? If you want something, you have to go get it. You have to put in the work. And this is something your person do not understand, okay? They try to do a lot at one time and then they end up doing nothing. So if this person is juggling you with someone else, then you will definitely be giving up on them because they cannot clearly make their mind, okay? So they are confused and you can't deal with it. But for others of you, if it's not a third party situation, I see this person is trying to manage their career and finance. And they also want you and they clearly don't know how to manage. So it's like they'll miss you. They want to work, make it work with you, but they have emotions as well. This person loves you. There's no doubt about it. They love you, but that action is missing, okay? Which they will be doing. Ultimately, they will do. It's like when you stop putting in the action, that's when this person is going to do that. But for now, till the time you are bending over backwards, they will just take you for granted. That sort of energy. So what's the outcome here? Emperor. See? You know, emperors can be good, but emperors can also be one of those people who just, you know, they're very much in their own ego. So they will not put in the work because they know other people will do the work for them. So if you are someone who's trying to boost somebody's ego because they are not putting in the work and you are overcompensating, stop doing it. Because this is giving a lot of ego boost to this person and they will not put the work ever. So make them accountable, okay? So what's up next then for my Virgo, please? Death card. Again, see, if you try to overcompensate, overwork the situation, it won't work. It will crumble. One side of the person or one side of the situation cannot handle the next side, okay? If it's a connection, both have to work together. And I see that this person, I mean, they will only work when you give up completely. And till the time you try to work it out, they won't. That's the problem. All right, anything else? Eight of Wands. However, I see this person coming in. See, again, Ten of Wands at the bottom of the deck. So, the same message, if you're trying to overcompensate in this connection, you're trying to make everything work by yourself, stop doing it. When you give up, that's when this person is going to come in. Okay? Till the time they know that you are there, they won't do it. So, it's an unrequited love kind of situation. Because they feel or you feel that there is no attraction left for this to work, you need to give up on this for some time, okay? You need to let loose. All right, give me a message for Virgo, please. Romance angel cards. Give me a message for Virgo. So we have honeymoon. So you might go holidaying together later on. Stay optimistic about your love life and worth waiting for. So yeah, if you want this connection to work, I definitely see very soon they might be making an offer to you. But it's going to happen when you let loose and you don't try to do everything by yourself. Like if it's a connection, if it's a partnership, it has to be 50-50, okay? You can't do everything by yourself. And if you're asking me whether you should wait or not, then yeah, you should if you truly want to invest in it. But it's going to take some time. So you have to have patience and don't become a second best priority to someone. Like, don't put yourself there, okay? If you become the second best option, people will treat you like one. And if you tell, fuck it, I'm not going to be the second best option, then nobody will treat you as such. Okay, so let's take the crystal ball oracle. Give me a card for Virgo, please. You're going in the right direction. So, you know, you pulling back and you letting loose is the right direction. You need not second guess. Give me one more card for Virgo, please. So we have listen to your intuition. So pay attention to your intuition and let go at the bottom of the deck. See what's telling you, you know. Your intuition is telling you to let go, but some of you might be freaking out that if I let go of this person, they might never come back. Don't do that, okay? Let go. Listen to your intuition that your self-respect is important. Always keep your self-respect above your feelings. That's when people treat you right. If you become a doormat, you stay a doormat, okay? Always remember. So yeah, that was a very beautiful reading. I definitely see very soon this person will be making a move towards you. But for that, you have to let go. You have to let loose. Don't become a second best option to someone, okay? Value your self-respect. Be in your power. Focus on your stability. This person is not going anywhere. So that was a reading. Hope this helps and resonate. If it does, subscribe, like, share, comment. I will see you very soon in the next video. You guys take care. Bye.